Is it me, or have there been a ton of plane crashes lately? Yeah, I'm heavily considering never stepping on a plane again. Hey folks, Laci Green here for D News. There was MH370, MH17, TransAsia 222, and Algeria Flight 5017. It's all so tragic, and my God, it's so many flights down. What the heck is going on? Despite all these closely occurring crashes lately, officials from the Atmosphere Research Group and Flight Safety Foundation both say that air travel remains extremely safe. And I do mean extremely. Air travel is safer than it's ever been. So safe that the experts say that being on a plane is probably the safest part of your day. There's a 1 in 11 million chance that you'll die in a plane crash, a chance so small that it's more likely you'll die in the airport itself. And nearly 96% of those who are in a plane crash survive. But you know what's way more fatal? Driving in a freaking car. Cars are death machines. You have a 1 in 5,000 chance of being killed in a car. That's right, we should really fear the ride to the airport more than the flight itself. Still, fears about flying in planes are widespread. 6% of people refuse to get on a plane outright because they're so paralyzed with fear. It's a condition called aviophobia, but up to 40% of people say they experience some anxiety when they're on a plane. What's at the heart of this widespread fear? Well, one is the psychological effect of hearing about every plane crash. They're so rare that when they do happen, word spreads around the world. If we heard about every single fatal car crash in the world, you bet your bottom people would be much more terrified of cars. But more so than the high visibility of plane crashes is the fact that flying reminds us how little control we have over life and death. Being behind the wheel of a car provides a greater illusion of control, but in neither situation are you completely in control of your own destiny. For many, flying provides varying degrees of confrontation with our own vulnerability and the true fragility of life. Fear of flying can also be exacerbated by other elements of the experience, you know, being in small spaces, feeling crowded, processing lots of strange noises, doing a lot of waiting, or not understanding the mechanics of how the thing actually flies. Every single time I'm on a plane, I'm just in awe of how they work. But a simple lack of understanding about flight basics can make things like turbulence go from harmless side effect to full-blown panic attack. So if you have a little anxiety while you're flying, or if your fear is stoked by hearing about all these crashes, it might help to read up about how safe flying actually is and how it works. I fly a lot, and learning a bit about it has definitely helped me out. Thanks for joining me for D News, everyone. Are you scared of flying? Let me know down below, and I'll catch you next time.